Let's graph the linear equation for y equals 3x plus 5. And we're going to do this two ways. First, we'll use a table of values. Then we'll check our work with slope-intercept formula. So let's put some values in for x, get a value for y, then we'll graph it here. Let's start out with 0, because 3 times 0, that's just 0, plus 5. We get 5 for our y. You can choose any values for x and they'll give you a value for y, and that point will be on our line for y equals 3x plus 5, but it's helpful if we choose values that fit here on the graph paper. So how about if we choose 1? Because 3 times 1, that's 3, 3 plus 5 is 8, and then if we put negative 1, 3 times negative 1, that's negative 3 plus 5, that'll give us 2. So these are the points that we'll graph for the equation y equals 3x plus 5. So we go to x is 0, y is 5, x is 1, y is 8 over 1 and 8. And we could stop there and draw a line with two points, but it's good to have a third point. Make sure you did this part correctly. So x is negative 1 and y is 2. And you can see they all line up. Let's put a line through that. Let's put arrows on that to show that this goes to infinity. So this is the line for the linear equation y equals 3x plus 5. Let's check our work with slope-intercept formula. So we have y equals mx plus b. B is the y-intercept. That's positive 5. That's where our line is going to cross the y-axis. So we go to 5, and right there it is. Next, we could think about the slope, m. That's 3, but we could call this 3 over 1. It's still 3, but now we can say rise over run. So let's go to our y-intercept. We'll go up 1, 2, 3, and over 1. Right there on the line. We could go up 1, 2, 3, and over 1, but we've run out of graph paper. So let's go back to the y-intercept and go the opposite direction. Go down 1, 2, 3, and over 1 to the left. We could do that again. Down 1, 2, 3, over 1 to the left. All these points are on our line, so we did this correctly. This is the graph for y equals 3x plus 5. And this is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.